What's up, guys? Kakatapos ko lang magbigay ng speech sa Hope Christian, pero ito yung opening ko dahil I just wanna talk to you guys about how awesome of an experience that was. Sobrang iba-iba sa akin. That was my first time talking for students. And noong una, sobrang ako nervous kasi syempre, I'm still very young and I'm still learning as well. So, you know, being able to share the knowledge that you have is very important. Kahit na sinasabi mong bata ka pa and you don't know much, when you feel like you can help someone, you know, share it with people, and it's very important because you never know if it can help someone, will affect anyone. Always have that mentality that you want to help people through your experiences and through your knowledge. And also have space to grow and have space to learn, because that's very important to be able to take in knowledge all the time. Hope you guys enjoy this video. Hope you guys learned something from it. If you have any comments or anything else you want to say about the topic of how to handle criticism, just comment it down below or tweet me at @1inigopascual or comment it on my Instagram @inigopascual or my Facebook, Inigo Pascual, with a checkmark on it, or just simply leave it in the comment section down below. Ayun, maraming salamat. Sana nag-enjoy kayo. And yun.
So we'll be coming in from the backstage. We'll introduce you.
Super excited. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for being here.
We appreciate it.
Various activities like this iSearch Forum. It's a part we want to tackle, you know, different issues students face today.
Yeah, that's nice.
We still get nervous.
One month, especially with talks. Before talking was my biggest asking ask, because it's kind of like some of the emotions.
Palagi kang out of town, pero palagi ka naman nagmamayabang. Then who would want to be your friend? Mga freeloaders. So the first step is to do things with a good and pure heart. Do not brag about what you have. Be thankful for everything that you have. If you start doing things out of good intention, you won't feel guilty about anything. Pero syempre, people will still criticize you. That will never go away. People will always say negative or positive things about you. But at least you know that you're not doing anything to hurt others or to make others feel bad. And again, there's not much we can do to remove criticism from the world, especially in this generation. Step two is to know what type of criticism you are getting. There are many types of criticism. But there are three that I think are mostly evident in this generation. There's constructive criticism, destructive criticism, and self-criticism. Constructive criticism, yun yung pag may ginawa kang maganda, pero bibigyan ka ng advice or tip on how you can make it better. Para sa akin, siguro, when I write songs, I always send my songs to Maurice or kay Moira. Because I know they will be honest with how they think about my songs. They'll give me honest opinions. Silang dalawa yung tipong pag sinend ko yung song ko, sobrang proud ako, sobrang excited ako, tapos hinihintay ko na lang yung compliments nila. Pero sasabihin nila sa'yo, maganda siya, okay siya. Pero mas okay sana kung palitan mo itong word na to, or palitan mo itong melody na to, or palitan mo yung buong kanta, pero maganda siya. That's constructive criticism. It's when someone gives advice on how you can make things better. Destructive criticism naman, ito yung nakakainis. Ito yung parang medyo pointless na criticism. Yung pag nagpagupit at pupunga po ka sa sarili mo, or gantang-ganda ka sa sarili mo dahil nagaya mo na yung bangs dun sa favorite K-pop or K-drama mo. Sasasabihin sa'yo nung kaibigan mo, ano ba yan? Mukha kang bunot. And then, there's self-criticism. Dito ako pinaka naapektuhan. Now, there's different types of self-criticism. Pwede din siya maging constructive, pwede din siya destructive. Depende yan sa tao. Minsan tayo mismo yung nagda-down sa sarili natin. Yung mga inisip natin, thoughts like, hindi ko kaya to, or hindi ako enough. Bakit bang pangit ko ngayon? Bakit bang awkward ko ngayon? Thoughts like this can destroy how we live. And these are the thoughts that limits our capabilities. And that's why we have to remember that we have a limitless God. He is able to work wonders through us, and we are capable of doing so much because our Creator called us His own. We simply do not deserve any of this. We do not deserve the grace and kindness He's given us, but He still gives it generously. And sana huwag natin sayangin yun. Step 3, to know how to handle criticism. We are humans. We are built to learn. Walang taong pinanganak na kusang alam nila lahat tungkol sa mundo. Remember that there is always room to grow, so we should be able to accept criticism and turn it into positive thoughts and actions. Every time you are criticized, think, is this person concerned? Is this constructive or destructive? Reflect, how can this be beneficial to me? How can I turn this into a positive thought? How can I use this to motivate me? And then adjust. Pagpasalamat sa tao, thank you so much for your criticism, whether positive or negative, at least they show concern sa'yo. And then use this criticism as fuel to push you to become better. So here are the things to remember when you are criticized. Remember that you are the son or daughter of God. It says in 1 John 3:1, see what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know Him. Even when we do not deserve His love, even when we sin against Him, kahit makakalimutan natin siya, He still claims us His own children. It says that the world does not know us because it did not know Him. If it did not know Him, then it doesn't know us. Then why should we be offended from negative comments about us? The only one that truly knows us more than we know ourselves is our Creator Himself. Second, give a gentle response. When you are criticized, it says in Proverbs 15:1, a soft answer turns wrath away. Turns away wrath. So bago ka ma-offend, breathe. Never decide or do things out of sudden emotions of anger and sadness, because this is temporary. Be gracious even to those who offend you, even as God is gracious to us when we offend Him. And lastly, pray about the criticism. Ask God for wisdom. It says in Psalms 32:8, I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eye upon you. If we simply turn to Him, He will help us graciously.
This is the last part. So my answer to how to handle criticism is to simply find your purpose. Be an instrument for God to show His love for us. If you're passionate about one thing, isipin mo, binigay ng Diyos yun para sa'yo, for you to use it to show His love to others. And I hope you guys are able to reflect and use my experience to help you guys. Thank you so much. Maraming salamat.
Thank you so much, Kenny. How do you remain so positive in time on the criticism?
Oh, yeah.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Mike Dosey. Yeah. Hope you enjoyed this video.